Five statements are given about error checking methods. Check to show whether each statement applies to automatic repeat request, check digits, or checksum. Some statements may apply to more than one error checking method. So we have a table which has a couple of statements, and we've got each of our error checking methods. We're going to go through and discuss each of these error checking methods and draw a few diagrams to help explain that. That will then allow us to answer these statements and to write which one of these statements applies to which error checking method. Starting with ARQ, automatic repeat request, better known as ARQ, is an error checking method that is used on data transmission. When we're sending data from device A to device B, ARQ is going to ensure that B receives the correct information. The first thing that happens is A sends a packet of data to B. B is going to use another error checking method to check if this data is correct or not. If B determines that the data is indeed correct, it's going to send back what is known as an acknowledgement, which can be abbreviated to ACK, A-C-K. Whilst B is doing this process, A starts a timer. If the ACK is received before this timer expires, then A knows that B has the correct information. If the timer expires, we get what's known as a timeout. If the timeout is reached, A is going to send back the exact same packet of data to B, as it's going to assume that B did not receive the correct information, or the packet got lost during its transmission. This process repeats until B sends back a positive acknowledgement before the timeout is reached. There are two main ways in which ARQ can operate. It can either operate using what's called a positive acknowledgement, or it can operate using a negative acknowledgement. Using a positive acknowledgement, when B receives the data and determines it is correct, it'll send back this acknowledgement, which is going to be known as a positive acknowledgement. A is going to receive this positive acknowledgement before the timeout, and data transmission can continue. With negative acknowledgement, when A sends data and B receives this data, if it determines it to be correct, it won't send anything back to A. If it determines that the data is incorrect, it'll send back what's known as a negative acknowledgement. That would then tell A that it needs to resend the data. Let's go through now each of these statements and tick which ones apply to ARQ. First off, checks for errors on data entry. There are two different types of error checking methods. We have data entry and data transmission. ARQ is a type of data transmission method, so we won't tick this one for ARQ. The next one says uses a process of acknowledgement and timeouts. That is what we're using over here, so let's go ahead and tick this. The next one says compares two calculated values to see if an error has occurred. With ARQ, we're not doing any comparisons, so that does not apply. The next one says may resend data until it is confirmed as received. Since this process gets repeated until we get a positive acknowledgement, then this does apply. And the last one says checks for errors in data after transmission from a computer to another. With ARQ, we are checking for errors during the transmission, so this does not apply for ARQ. The next error checking method we have is the check digits. Check digit is an error checking method that we use when we are entering data into a computer. The most common example is when we're entering barcodes. For example, if we're at a shop and the barcode scanner doesn't work, we might want to enter the barcode. However, the barcode is a long number, and it's very easy for humans to make mistakes while entering data. For this reason, we would want to use a check digit to ensure that the data entered is correct without knowing what the correct data is. Let's say that we have a barcode number that looks like this. This number is a very long number to enter, and it's very easy to make mistakes. So we're going to apply an algorithm. For IGCSE, we don't have to know what this algorithm is, but there is an algorithm we can apply that's going to use all of these digits and is going to come up with a single number. Let's say that this number is 2. We add this to the end of the barcode, and this becomes our completed barcode. Now, when we enter this into the computer will redo the calculation using the first 13 digits. If it gets the same number that we got, then we know that the number has been entered correctly. If we don't get the same number, then the number was entered incorrectly. The reason this method is called the check digit method is because this value we add to the end is called the check digit. Let's now go through our table, checking if each statement applies to the check digits column. The first one says checks for errors on data entry. In this case, we're entering data and we're checking if we've entered the correct data. So this will apply. The next one uses a process of acknowledgement and timeouts. That won't apply since that only applies to ARQ. The next one compares two calculated values to see if an error has occurred. In this case, we are comparing the value that we entered with the computer's calculated value. So that does apply. The next one may resend data until it is confirmed as received. In this case, we only enter the data once and it tells us if we get an error or not. So that is not going to apply. The next one checks for errors in data after transmission from a computer to another. Here, a human is entering data into a computer, so this does not apply. The last method we have is the checksum method. The checksum method is going to work very similar to how the check digit works. The difference here is that we're going to be using it for data transmission. Imagine that we have some data to send. We can split that data up into packets and we can represent those packets as numbers. For example, the numbers 14, 75, 101, 57, 82, and 6. We can apply an algorithm very similar to the one that we apply for the check digit to work out a number that we add to the end. For example, this number could be 127. We then add this number to our packet and we send this entire packet over to our receiving computer. The receiving computer does the same calculation that we've just done and works out the checksum value. This checksum value is then compared to our checksum value. If it is correct, that means that all of the data sent is correct. And just like with check digit, the reason why this method is called checksum is because the value that we generate is called the checksum. Let's go through our table and tick which ones apply. The first one checks for errors on data entry. The checksum method is an error checking method for data transmission, so this does not apply. Uses acknowledgement and timeouts. Again, since that only applies to ARQ, it doesn't apply for checksum. Compares two calculated values to see if an error has occurred. In this case, that is going to be true, since the receiving computer is recalculating the checksum and comparing it to the received checksum. May resend data until it is confirmed as received. That does not apply since we are not requesting for retransmission if the checksum is incorrect. And lastly, checks for errors in data after transmission from a computer to another. This is going to be true. We're going to send our entire packet. It's then going to check if the checksum is correct after the transmission has completed. Question B says identify one other error checking method. Here we could mention a parity check, the method of which we've gone through in a previous video. And there we go. That is our completed question.